So good day everyone. Today we'll be discussing about risk factors for COPD. COPD, as we all know, is a chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, which is basically a combination of emphysema and bronchitis. It is the third leading cause of death worldwide, and it is likely to become the leading cause of death worldwide in about 15 years time. Most important risk factor worldwide is of course cigarette or tobacco smoking, which could be in the form of cigarettes, could be BDs or hookahs. These contain volatile compounds which go and damage your lung, and this can lead to what we call, what in common parlance call as bronchitis, and in medical parlance you'll call it as COPD. There are almost 600,000 deaths which occur every year due to smoking, which is entirely preventable. The second most important cause worldwide is air pollution, which could be either outdoor air pollution or indoor air pollution. Indoor air pollution is particularly important in the third world or the developing world country, where rural areas, women are using biomass fuels such as wood, coal or other combustible material for fuel for cooking. And most of the homes are poorly ventilated. As a result, the byproducts of these fuels are stay within the room, and the women, especially, and children get exposed to that and can develop COPD in later life. Other important factors are genetic factors such as alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency, which causes higher susceptibility to smoking and more severe forms of COPD, especially in a younger age group, as well as childhood infections, recurrent childhood infections, and tuberculosis, which is known to cause develop COPD as a sequelae in a significant number of patients. So avoiding smoking, getting controlling your indoor and outdoor air pollution, and as well as controlling infections in childhood, as well as tuberculosis, these are some of the preventable risk factors, and if we take care of them, we can reduce the burden of COPD, which is causing a great cost to healthcare in terms of healthcare around the world, and is, as we know already, the third leading cause of death worldwide.